Welcome to the first episode of Surviving with Create and More. I put together a mod pack for 1.18.2 Minecraft using CurseForge. And my plan for this pack is to utilize these mods and the cool structures that some of these mods add to the pack. We're going to use Create. We're going to use the new trains, and we're going to set up a train network that's going to go to these structures that we're going to repurpose into Create factories to make stuff and things. This is a list of all the mods that are in the pack. It's scrolling kind of fast. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to also add it to the YouTube title description, a list of the mods that are in here. And you, if you want to play along at home, can add these mods very simply using CurseForge. Click right here, create custom profile. It opens this up. Give it a name. Minecraft version. Change this to 1.18.2. We're using Forge. So you want to add the latest Forge version. Click create. And that's going to do a thing. And it's going to add your mod pack right here. And then right click on here. Click add more content. And you can add all the mods in to the pack. If you're new to the channel, I'm Tube. This guy right here that we found in the intro of the video is Knuckle. And we would like to say welcome to the channel. Now, let's get started. This building that Knuckle and I are in, I didn't build. It's part of a mod called Integrated Dungeons and Structures. And so far from what I've seen, these are the coolest structures that any mod has ever added in my time of playing Minecraft. The downside of it is you gotta have Alex's mobs in the pack, and I almost died to an alligator, and these dudes don't like me either. I took my armor off for the intro. Good thing I put it back on, and I found this thing. This thing is better. I got big plans for this playthrough, but everything has to start small. So stupid. To be fair, they are kind of giants. But what I meant to say was I already punched a fair amount of trees, did a decent amount of digging and mining, got some sheep, we got a good wool supply, and found a scarf. Now let's get into doing some create stuff. I almost forgot. There's my seed, in case you're interested. The goal of this first episode is I added a farm. We're growing wheat, carrots, potatoes. I want to automate this farm using the Create mod. And I also want to automate this tree farm using the Create mod. But in order to do anything with Create, you have to create rotational force. I said create a lot there. In the basement, we're putting in a windmill. That's how we're going to generate our first source of rotation. This is a vertical gearbox. We're going to put that like that. I'm going to take a windmill bearing. I'm going to attach it right there. And then I'm going to take a piece of wool and we're going to add sails around this. I'm going to put two stacks of sails attached to here. I got one shaft going that direction. That's where the farms are. Another shaft is going this direction. We're going to bring it down that wall and we're going to put some Create apparatuses here so we can start making things. And there's our fan. That's two stacks of sails in there. And I'm pretty sure that that is the max that you can get out of a Create fan. A strong breeze is what we get. We need iron plates to make the mechanical saws and the mechanical harvesters that we're going to use for these automations. Now, because I have other mods in this pack, there's different, easier ways to make it. But I'm going to concentrate on making everything that I'm doing with Create. So here's my line coming down from the fan. We're going to put a vertical gearbox there. We're going to put our mechanical press there, a depot right there, and then we'll take a stack of iron. We'll pop the iron on there, and the press, while it be slow, is still going to bonk. 10 years later, we got our stack of iron. We also need three pieces of gold smushed into plates so that we can make the Create wrench to make this whole process a little easier. We could take our iron plates, and we need 12 mechanical harvesters for what we're going to do. And we also need a tube of super glue. Let's see if we can get these farms going. Above here is where the farms are. So I need to bring over a shaft to power farms. We're going to bring it over right there. Take a vertical gearbox, put it in there. Now that shaft is spinning. And now I want all these to spin the same direction. So I'm going to keep bringing this shaft down. And then right here, I'm going to put double gearbox. And what that's going to do is going to change the rotation of this back to spinning the same as the first one. And we're going to do the same thing for the last one. Bring it over. Then double gearbox off of this guy. And they should all three be spinning the same direction. Let me just go up top to verify that. All right, all three of these are spinning counterclockwise. So now that we know that, we can go down, back downstairs, kill the power of the rotation of them, and then we'll come back up and we'll build the mechanical harvesters, is what I was going to say. But before I turn this off, I forgot one thing. These things that we're building are going to harvest this stuff, and it needs somewhere to put them. So my plan is we're going to run a belt right along the front here, and I'll put drawers in front of it with funnels that'll pull the items off the belt into there. But we need to make sure the belt is spinning the right way. So we're going to come off of here, run shafts over. That's too many. Vertical gearbox up, and then bring our shaft up. Let me climb out of here. That's spinning the wrong way. So that's an easy fix. We just need to double the gearbox. That changes the rotation. And now we can put a shaft on there. And I want to put a belt all the way across here, but I don't think one belt will reach that far. So we'll split it somewhere in the middle, just like so. And I'll bring the belt over to here. Now, belts are easy to make. You just get kelp, melt it, and then six pieces of kelp in a crafter make the belt. That one's spinning the right way. And then one last thing, these are encased chain drives. The recipe for these is very simple. And what this does, it'll carry the rotation through the chain and make these belts spin the same direction. Perfect. We can now set up our item collection. So I put a drawer here. I put carrots inside there. We're going to line up with the center of the farm. I'm going to put a chute down and then take a portable storage interface and come on this side. And we're going to put that right there. And then on these contraptions, I'll have portable storage interfaces. These will interact. It'll drop the carrots down. I need to make funnels to pull them in from the backside. But I just wanted to show how this can be done. I'm going to put two drawers here. This is the potato farm right here. So we're going to get potatoes and also poisonous potatoes. And same deal with this one. Center of the farm. We're going to put a chute down and portable storage interface facing in just like that. And then for the wheat farm, that's the center. So we want to come over to box. We're going to get wheat seeds and also wheat from here. So we'll put wheat in one box, wheat seeds in another box, line up with the center of the farm, funnel. That's not a funnel, that's called a chute, and a portable storage interface, but we don't want it facing up like that because it won't do a darn thing. We need it going that way. Now let's build these contraptions. We're going to use mechanical bearing to power this. The recipe for these is pretty simple. But what this does is it's going to take the rotation. We know that this shaft, when powered, spins counterclockwise. So we'll put the bearing right on top of there. And that's going to transfer the energy from the shaft to our contraption. I'm putting spruce planks across here, just like so. And then we need four harvesters in front on the side that this is going to spin. So it's going that way. It's going to harvest the wheat. And then the last thing, or the two last things that we need, one is a chest. We need to put a chest on there so that when this harvests, it has somewhere to put the stuff, or else it'll just stay in your world, and we don't want that. And the other last thing that we need is we need to bring over just like that, and then we're going to take a portable storage interface, put that on top of there, so now when this thing spins around, it's going to interact with that one. It's going to drop the wheat and the seeds onto that belt and hopefully put them in the drawer once I put funnels on the backside of them. The last thing that we have to do to this is glue it all together. Or else when we turn it on, the only thing that would spin is this one block. So you click on there, boom, bring the glue over. And you just want to cover everything that's on your contraption with super glue. Just like that. So while you're holding it, you can see it all is highlighted with that green color. And this thing's good to go. I got to build two more. We'll fire them up. I'll bring you back. And I don't think we're getting to the tree farm today because this one's getting a little long. The fun of Minecraft. Somehow they spawned right on top of me while I was gluing that last contraption together. And I wasn't recording the whole thing. But we have the three contraptions built. The last thing you got to do is add funnels to the backside of these. Notice how the arrow is pointing towards the belt. We don't want that. So take the wrench, right click on there, and they'll go into the drawer, or you can shift while putting it and it'll face the correct way. Now we're set up. I think we're ready to rock and roll. The last thing I gotta do is go repower this and then run up here. I hope everything works, and then I'll fix the farms. Don't run around with funnels in your hands because you'll empty every inventory you click on. Poop tip of the day. Have a shaft. I do. Perfect. Oh, it's doing, moving with a purpose. I like it. It's doing something. Hopefully it's doing the right thing. We're getting all kinds of achievements. Folks, I think we have great success. And that is the end of the episode. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Have fun and peace.